There we go. Look at us. Your mom and dad are behind us. Your foster mom and dad are behind us. This is Katasha. I got an email from a gal we worked with before down in Kentucky. She said, I'm involved with the local shelter, and I believe I've contacted you before when I was doing the volunteer rescue coordinator position. This time I have a personal need. My aunt and uncle have a husky named... Okay, her name was Sasha, but we've had so many. Her rescue name is Katasha, so when she's adopted, she probably knows Sasha, and I call her that. I know that's always confusing, but we have to have kind of unique identities here. Anyway, said, she has been with them about 8 years. She is cross-eyed, which she is. We'll get close-ups of her later. Yeah, and loves people. She does great with male dogs and submissive females. She is the alpha female, though. And we'll ask, remind me to ask you about her and Juno.
Yep.
She hasn't been vetted in a couple of years, but she is spayed. I honestly don't know about her heartworm status either, but we can take her to be tested. Before I forget, she is heartworm positive, a light positive, and we'll get that treated. She, you know, she's a, well, clearly not underweight, so she should be strong. It's early on. She should do great with the treatment.
What is this?
Says she needs rescue. She's the only outside dog now, and my uncle has been diagnosed with terminal cancer, which is progressing very quickly. He's on hospice, and his wife can't keep up with her needs while caring for him. Is there any way you can help? I can help with the transporting and anything else I can do. She weighs 65 pounds and was updated on vaccinations today. As we mentioned, she was heartworm positive. Let's see. She's special to me because she belonged to my uncle, and the uncle has passed since then, but the wife wasn't in a position to take care of her either. So we were happy to help a dog like this who really needs a break. She came into the shelter system in the first place when she was very young. They did have volunteers come, and I think she's had a bath now, hasn't
yes,
she?
Yes. She feels like and smells like she
has. Okay, yes. Okay. I guess she was pretty much a mess, and we did have pictures, I think, of a couple volunteers at the shelter that gave her a good brushing out before she came up here. So she just needs some love and TLC, and we have just the ticket for her. PD and Diane are behind me. They are her foster parents and very, very involved volunteers who come in on Saturdays and do a lot of adoptions and so forth. So why don't you come up, either of you, close enough behind me that the camera will hear you, and just talk about how she's doing in the house, how she's doing with Polo and Juno. Mention Cindy, bless her heart, you know, because that's a vulnerable dog that she was good with. So just free form for me and tell me everything you've learned about her.
Well, we brought her last Sunday to our house, and we have three other huskies at that time we did. One is a rather dominant male, one is a rather submissive female, and then Cindy was 15 years old, and she just liked to sleep a lot. When we brought Katasha into the yard, she growled at both Juno and Polo, and they just looked at her and kind of backed off, and then they were good buddies. So there was nothing. There was nothing at all. And Cindy was sleeping in the living room at the time. When we brought Katasha in, they just kind of sniffed each other, no big deal at all. At one point, Katasha and Cindy were sharing a dog bed that night.
Aww.
So she walks beautifully. I think she'd be a perfect starter husky because she's just...
And she's 9 years old. I did not mention that. I mean, that's a great age. It's mature, but you know, they can live up to 16. So.
Yeah. And she walks nicely on leash. She loves getting pets. She prefers right now. She's lived her life outside. We understand. So she prefers right now to be on our porch, which is kind of a three-season porch. Sleeps right in front of the door, getting into the house.
Okay.
When we bring her in the house, she pants a little bit. She's a little anxious, but once she settles down, she just comes up to us and asks for a pet.
Aww.
She's just a little snuggle buddy.
Little so, is she.
Yeah.
Very affectionate.
Yeah.
And as far as the housebreaking, are you, I mean, is she, are you working on that?
I think she is.
Okay.
We had one accident in the house, and it was the very first day she came out.
Okay, well, that, I mean, that's just, maybe she was in a house at one point.
Yeah.
And remembered, because I mean, to have one accident going from living outside all the time straight into your house, that's wonderful.
Yeah, yeah. No, that's it. So I think she is, and we pay attention too. We make sure she, and of course she prefers to be on the porch, so.
Right.
Yeah, she's.
Now, she's been to the vet and they did an exam. How did that go? Were they checking for UTI maybe, right?
Yeah, no UTI.
Okay.
They said that she's obviously drinking a lot. She was healthy.
That can be stress too.
Yeah,
I mean,
exactly,
a lot of times.
Exactly.
All of us can drink.
Yeah,
we're stressed, right?
Exactly.
Something or another.
Yeah, exactly.
That really the biggest thing is that she's a little heavy for her frame.
Yeah.
But and of course the heartworm. But other than that, her lab work, they did a senior panel on her, and her lab work shows a couple things are high, but there was no concern. The doctor said we would expect that with the heartworm.
Okay.
So they felt that she'll be ready for her treatment once she gets through the doxy.
Yeah, the prior gal started her on the doxy before she came up here, right?
Yeah, she's been on the doxy for 2 weeks now. Yep.
Okay, and you had mentioned her back legs. I mean, do we think that that's maybe a little bit of arthritis and then weight? Or,
yes,
I mean, clearly getting weight off of her is going to be the best thing you can do with
Absolutely.
Those back legs.
Absolutely. She does well on walks. She can keep up with Juno and Polo. And it was, we trotted a little bit this morning, and she did fine. But
Good
they
girl.
Did say that her back end is a little stiff. But
yeah,
they suggested fish oil and glucosamine
right.
to kind of help.
Right, right.
Other than that, she's a healthy girl.
And what was her weight?
65.
Okay.
65.
And she probably should weigh, I would think 50 at the most.
Well,
yeah.
She's Juno's size, and Juno is 45.
Juno's a really trim one, though, too.
She
like,
is.
I mean, naturally really trim.
Yeah,
so,
she is.
Yeah. So, I, you know, like 50. So, I mean, that's an assignment, but I know you guys feel like I do about overweight huskies, and you mentioned maybe putting her on some green beans too.
Well, you know, she is not, she really doesn't
overeat.
She doesn't overeat at all. We free feed and it's okay. I think she just maybe needs the better grade of food.
Yeah.
Yeah,
and she is so, I mean, that in part two could be just outside and not getting any exercise because her coat, we see this in dogs that have been outside. I want to just zoom in. Hi, it's okay. You can see in front of her ears and on her face, she's and behind her ears, she's got this beautiful kind of chocolatey mahogany color. And when her healthy coat comes in with a good diet, all the red parts of her should be that color, not this like yellowy, orangey, sun bleached color. What is he doing? Is he snuggling you? And all those dogs hate Aunt Bev. So I mean, we get a little weight off her. Those legs are going to feel stronger. Her coat's going to look like her coat will match her beautiful, beautiful face. And she's going to be a stunning dog. So like Diane said, we'll walk her by the cats too. I don't know what the answer on that one was. We'll see how she reacts.
You know, on our walk this morning, there was, she's run into cats and squirrels and she hasn't reacted.
Really?
Yeah.
So, maybe she's even cat possible. So a dog like that, well, of course, if she wants to be outside all the time, I would say she'd be a good apartment dog just for her energy level. But she probably wants a tree to lay under and a porch to hang out on, and she deserves that. So we'll come in for, I haven't even squeaked to get her to look at me. Although she's been a good girl. Let's see if I can get her to look at me, and then we'll do our kiss cam and get some pictures of her. What is that? What is that? There we go. Look at that face. You are she's so pretty.
Isn't she?
You're very pretty girl.
Those
what is that?
I
love those crosses.
Siamese dog, huh?
Yeah. Well, remember Clarence the Lion? We're all old enough to remember Dr. Tari.
Yeah.
This is the only crowd probably I'd be safe bringing that up where I know what I was talking about. There was Clarence the Cross-Eyed Lion. So that's a good girl. So give us a kiss. Give us a kiss for the kiss cam. Oh, that's a good girl. That's a pretty, pretty girl. We're going to walk around and just see, again, foster mom Diane said she saw a squirrel and what else?
Cat.
And a cat on a walk, and she didn't react.
You need to play cats.
Let's go say hi to my buddy Bob.
It's like you're going inside.
Oh, she looks, she's like, no, I don't want, no, nope. There we go. We staring down.
She's just
no, she's being not even with the kitty being kind of. Okay,
awesome.
She's gonna swat. I'll walk over here then. Where's my buddy Bob?
Right here.
I love Bob. I'm so tempted to take him home.
Would Gracie allow it?
I think Gracie probably is fine with Gracie's. Gracie's just a little pussycat herself. I like that orange one too. See, marmalade, so tangerine, what's his name? One of those.
Yes. He's a marmalade cat. I don't know what
that is. Okay. Okay, Missy, I think you would definitely be potentially cat workable.
She doesn't